Guys, Jimmy, your Chaos Officer, welcome back.
What's up, everybody? I've got some gameplay for you from R7 Response on Firing Range 63-2, I think, or something like that. Check out his channel. Link in the description. Very sexy gameplay. I love watching gameplay on Firing Range. It never gets old to me. It's one of the best maps in Call of Duty. And before it don't start with, oh, you don't put up your own gameplay, Jimmy. I do a lot, and I try to more. But with Modern Warfare 3 and Black Ops, it's not really that big a deal. It's just a backdrop for the videos I do because I don't talk about the gameplay very often. But that kind of rotates when Black Ops 2 gets here, and we go into all about the gameplay for a couple months. Anyway, enjoy the gameplay. I want to talk about this is a magical mystery land where fairies and enchanted genies do special things, and you wake up in the morning, and somehow you are blessed with one wish. Actually, you don't even get a wish. You are just blessed with, you get to pick the next Call of Duty. You get to pick where it's going to be and what the backdrop's going to be, and I want to know what it would be. I was talking about this with a friend the other day about, oh, what do you want to see next? And we were debating back and forth, oh, it's going to be Call of Duty in space because that's the way we're going. And obviously Black Ops 2, there may be a Black Ops 3, and they're not going to take us anywhere but space because it's futuristic, blah, blah, blah. But if it was me and I got this magical Infinity War genie, Treyarch, Neversoft, whoever decides to make this next Call of Duty. Actually, I think there's two Call of Duties being made right now, and I'll go into that in a second. I personally would love to see it go backwards. I would love to see us go back around the Revolutionary War. I think that would be badass. I really do. I just think, I don't know. I don't know if that's where the new Assassin's Creed is set, is the Revolutionary War or the Civil War. I'm not for sure. But anywhere in those two timelines, I think would be badass. I think it'd be awesome to go back. Go back farther than World at War. Go back to, like I said, the Revolutionary War, the Civil War, something like that. And just throw us in the mix there. But just because all these guns, like the guns you see on Black Ops and Modern Warfare 3, and even Black Ops 2, a lot of them are familiar guns to us. Now, Black Ops 2 will have some new ones, obviously, but they're still the mix of your assault rifles and your submachine guns and stuff like that. It's stuff we're used to. If we went back in time to, say, the Civil War, we'd be using muskets and stuff like that. I mean, that would be awesome. I think that would be totally cool. A lot of people may not agree with me, but I think it would totally be a fresh take on Call of Duty, and I would thoroughly enjoy it because I'm sure the campaign and the plot and the timeline is just endless possibilities what they could do. And it'd be cool to see what kind of kill streaks. What kind of kill streaks would you get back then? I guess you could still get dogs. Maybe you could get like a baby mini mortar cannon or something that you roll around on wheels and you can launch it that way. What else could we get? Let me know in the comment section. That's the question for this video besides the topic of what Call of Duty would you make? Where would you put us? The other question is, what would you do for kill streaks if there was a Call of Duty set in the Civil War or Revolutionary War time period? I think you guys could get pretty creative with this. I'm trying to think of some more myself. Kill streaks. I guess they had planes back then, didn't they? Yeah, they had like biplanes and prop planes. I guess you could do something with a plane. You could definitely do dogs. I don't know what else you could do. That would be interesting to sit down and think about what kind of stuff you could make as a kill streak back in the day like that. Anyway, let me know in the comment section. But yeah, that's what I would personally do. If they came to me and gave me the keys to the Treyarch or Infinity Ward vehicle to decide what the next Call of Duty would be and where it would be, that's where I would go. I would go to the Revolutionary War, the Civil War time period, and rock it out and give it a fresh take. Now, is that going to happen? Probably not. We're probably going to go farther into the future, into space, because that's the way things go now. But I think it would be cool. And I said earlier, I think there's two Call of Duties being made right now, and I'm pretty sure Neversoft is working on something. I don't think Infinity Ward's out of the mix. So what I think is going on, this is me personally, a little tidbit for you guys. I think, obviously, they're working on the next Call of Duty, which will probably be an Infinity Ward title. Even though it's not Infinity Ward the crew, we know that. It's just the name, the brand. Maybe Sledgehammer, don't know. But I think that maybe Neversoft or somebody else is working on a Call of Duty MMO. I know we've talked about that in the past. I just don't see how that's not going to happen. MMOs are huge, and everybody wants to get online and mingle with people, and it just makes sense to have a Call of Duty massive multiplayer online experience. There's so many ways they could do it, and I think it would go over well if they did it right. So I really think that is being worked on. That's just my personal opinion, and I'd be curious to see it. I'd pay like $7.95 a month or something to be involved in a Call of Duty MMO if it actually reflected the game and what we're used to. I think it'd be cool, but we'll see. That's it, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. I hope you enjoy your Sunday. Be sure to rate and comment as always. Get active in the comment sections with me. Let's talk about what kill streaks we would bring back from the Revolutionary War if we had a Call of Duty, and where you would put Call of Duty in a timeline if you got to pick the next one. That's it, guys. As always, thanks for watching. Be sure to check out R7 Responses channel and thank him for the gameplay. Beast. Peace.